Game of Thrones, as complex as its writing is, always follows the simplest ways to tell it. And I think so they don't have another option. Because so much depth, so much history, which becomes a key catalyst to the present situations. So many characters, with every single one of them hitting the mark of character complexity, with ever-changing intentions and traits, with conflicting moral compass. So many locations where the progression of the story never stops. Sometimes. My point here is, the story itself is so complex that more complexity piled onto it could make it so exhausting that it just becomes nonsensical. So in order to create a scene having some emotional value, it's really important that the audience understands the stakes of the situations, and it shouldn't sound like this.
Okay, here they are. And when I hit this, yeah, they'll be able to see us. So come on and get in here close so we can be seen in the webcam. See how small the webcam is? No, get cheek to cheek. Nick, come here, take a cheek.
But don't crown me.
Nick, get cheek to cheek. Will you get your cheek?
I get you.
Buddy, they can't see us.
If you go
cheek to cheek, just go like a tree. Put your fucking cheeks next to mine.
I get it.
We can see you guys. Okay,
good. You got us?
Hi, my name is...
This failure of delivering only necessary information can be sorted in two groups. Group 1, greedy for subtlety. Here, so much effort has been put into diluting the information being provided in the complexities of time, place, and Tarantino-esque dialogue that it just becomes, as I said, nonsensical. In this group, creator assumes that the audience is watching and processing even the 1 second cuts so attentively in their giant intelligent brains that there's no way they can miss this amoeba-sized subtlety. Such a failure can often be noticed in super artsy student films where you don't get what's happening. Group 2.
What the fuck
is subtlety? In this group, they spoon-feed you the same information amplified to 1000 decibels attached to a loudspeaker again and again to the point we, as audience, just lose interest. Here, the creator assumes that the audience is super dumb and solving calculus while they're watching the movie, so they can't handle any other brain activity and just want to watch something move on the screen. So let's just give them exactly that. Believe it or not, a movie is nothing without information, which if the audience intuitively gets the basis of it, then it's fine. But when we are making movies or series, we are making worlds. Therefore, information about that world has to be communicated through that world. So finding that right balance of exposition just enough to trigger an abstract conflict is a perpetual struggle. And that brings us to the balance. Game of Thrones. Now, as vast as it is, I want to look at one really simple scene from the series which, honestly speaking, became my favorite in season 7. This scene is 3 minutes and 32 seconds long, starting from this brutal match cut. The context is, Arya is on her way to kill Cersei and meets Hot Pie. And from the point she left House of Black and White, this is the first time we see her interacting to a friend.
Who's that for? This is good.
You think so? Secret. It's browning the butter before making the dough. Well, most people don't do that because it takes up too much time.
I didn't do that.
You've been making pies?
One or two.
Can't believe you're in. Did you meet the big lady?
Big lady?
The lady knight? Yeah, I figured she was a knight because she had armor on. She was looking for your sister, but I told her about you. Did she ever find you?
She found me.
What happened to you, Harry?
You got any ale?
She seems different, right? It is as if by killing people on her list who represented her painful past, she killed her past itself.
Where are you heading?
King's Landing.
Why?
Heard Cersei's queen now.
Heard she blew up the Great Sept. That must have been something to see. Boom. Can't believe someone would do that.
Cersei would do that.
And then comes the conflict trigger.
I thought you'd be heading for Winterfell.
Why would I go there? The Boltons have it.
No, the Boltons are dead.
What?
Jon Snow came down from Castle Black with a Wilding army and won the Battle of the Bastards. He's King of the North now.
You're lying.
Why would I lie about that? He's your brother, right?
Thanks for the pie.
Friends don't pay. Can't believe I thought you were a boy. You're pretty.
Here the dilemma is introduced. Whether to go to King's Landing for her list versus her home. Now to understand the subtext in this scene, you need to know the phases of Arya's character. Number one is Arya. Number two is no one. And in the sixth season, episode 8,
a girl is Arya Stark of Winterfell. And I'm going home.
She made the choice between those two. But now, her own identity is further divided into Arya before Ned Stark's death and Arya after Ned Stark's death. Because believe me, they're completely different people. Coming back to her dilemma though, she basically is choosing between her family, her people, those who define her, versus the hate of her enemies. Now starts the fun part. We are introduced with the conflict, we know the character traits, we know its motivations and confusion. Now the time comes to create a moment. The moment is basically a payoff to the scene, the last dart hitting the bullseye. So now, as we come outside,
a girl is Arya Stark of Winterfell, and I'm going home.
This, I think, is one of the most efficient ways to evoke instant emotion. By giving us simple information, which gave rise to this conflict, which eventually created that moment, which paid off as an emotion. Now, evoking these instant emotions are not enough for better storytelling. It's just a tool to keep the audience keen for what's coming for the characters. In fact, Game of Thrones holds up with these simple techniques because of the character development they have done in the past. Because in my opinion, unlike movies, which are dependent on robust plots, a series is dependent on robust characters. But character development is a completely different beast. Something to be covered in a different essay.
Girl.